بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما.
I studied the books of Imam al-Albani رحمه الله extensively before I met him. When I was in Dubai, I was working there, was a manager of a charity organization. Al-Albani used to visit us during winter because in Jordan it was cold for him. So he used to come. Alhamdulillah, I attended dozens of classes when he was there. And I translated some of them. I have the tapes. Still, alhamdulillah, some of them are original. You can't find them anywhere else. Translated also some of his books. One of them for Dar Turath, and that was years ago. But in my own books that I wrote, like Zad al-Ma'ad, in the footnotes, I put a lot of that, you know, information about those aspects from the books of Imam al-Albani. I met him also in Jordan many, many times until he stopped going to the masajid because he was ill. Also, I prayed in his janazah, alhamdulillah. I was in the second line. So before I met him, he was my teacher. Imam al-Albani said very clearly, anyone who studies my books is one of my students, even if they didn't meet me. This is why before I met him, and I met him dozens and dozens of times, like I said, translated some of his books. Alhamdulillah, the involvement was more than merely sitting with him. But when I met him, my goal wasn't to learn more information about the religion. I already had established myself in the religion in a reasonable way, especially from his books. So when I met him, it wasn't like I wanted to hear more information. Alhamdulillah, his books are tremendous tools of knowledge for all generations to come. I wanted just to look at his face, because when you look at the face of the scholar, and the good scholar, you, from the face you will understand that these people are, they follow the sunnah. And from looking at his face, and his demeanor with his students and with his family, it just gave me the last assurance that this is one of the Imams of Islam who Allah gave us the opportunity to see. Sit with them, see how they behave. And subhanAllah, he wouldn't leave any aspect that has to do with the Sunnah without telling the people about it, even if it was something that's not required. I remember once we praying behind the Imam of the masjid that's connected to the charity organization where I was the manager. And that brother prayed Salat al-Asr. Al-Albani was behind him. We were all behind him. Then the Imam finished the Salah. He said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. He didn't leave him. He said, so Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh is not established to you? He said, no, it is established. It's just I rotate it. Sometimes I say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sometimes I say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This time, it was, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So he didn't even wait. And I heard about something that happened that I wasn't a witness, but subhanAllah. So he was praying next to someone who didn't sit the second tashahud as they should according to the sunnah, which is they sit on the left part of their buttocks, and they take the feet from underneath the buttocks and put it under the shanks of the right foot. This is the sunnah for the second tashahud. So I heard that when he was sitting next to somebody who didn't do that, when they finished the salah, it was a common man. So Sheikh didn't start telling him, that's different. The salah is different because that was a student of knowledge. So he didn't wait. He told this man, is there a sunnah you can teach me about the second tashahud, how you sit, you know, because I saw you sit like this. He said, no, this is the way I learned. He said, if this is the way you learned, then let me tell you about how you should sit. And he explained to him how you should sit for the second tashahud, subhanAllah. And another aspect that I heard on one of the tapes is that whenever he had debates with people, with especially young people, he had far more patience than we can have. Or we can imagine. He would let a 20-year-old for an entire hour say some of the most, sorry to say, stupid things that you can hear. Some people have in their life some kind of sickness, I don't know. The religion has tens of thousands of aspects. They choose one and two or two that they don't understand and they stick to it. It's like their mind is one track. Day and night they're thinking about this aspect only, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So we sat with Al-Albani to talk about how Allah, about the balance between the species Allah put on earth and everything and this and that. Ya akhi, choose something else. It's boring. But Al-Albani, Allah sat with him and was so patient. He allowed him to speak and talk, you know, take his chance. So when I saw Al-Albani, I didn't want to see him because I wanted to gain more specific knowledge about whatever. Of course, every time we met him, we learned something. But because I wanted to complete the picture about him, to see the man that he behaved according to what he preaches in the books. And that was enough for me, alhamdulillah. I didn't sit like other shuyukh sat with him years and years, but for me it was sufficient. The dozens of times I sat with him in, with other people, of course, in Dubai and in Amman before he died. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed me to be in his janazah. That was to me efficient and sufficient for me to say, I really met, in my view, the most knowledgeable man in our time. And I sat with him, I learned his books, and he's my teacher, he's my sheikh. So I wanted to explain this here because sometimes people think that when we say I'm a student of Al-Albani, I sat with him 15 years. You don't have to. Al-Albani didn't even say that. He said, you learn my books, you become one of my students. This is how I became one of the students. Also, I sat with him, met him. We rode in the same car a few times. It's just tremendous meeting that sheikh. I know people who met Ibn Baz and Al-Thaymin also say similar things about these people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us to have these kind of scholars in our time. And subhanAllah, all three of them died during the same year. All three of them. So inshallah ta'ala, yes, you can tell people I am a student of Al-Albani in the way I explain. I met him personally, translated some of his books, and also I studied his books extensively. But I'm not fanatical about any sheikh. Let me tell you, it's excellent to have a teacher to teach you from the beginning aspects of the religion. This is the normal way. But if it wasn't available to you, then you shouldn't be ignorant all your life. You should try to gain knowledge. Alhamdulillah, I think I learned so much knowledge on my own. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened my heart for the Salafi da'wah before I met Al-Albani or heard about Ibn Baz or Ibn Uthaymeen. Before. They were before me doing so many things for the da'wah. I became on the sunnah before I met them. And therefore, I can't say, well, this sheikh is my sheikh, meaning I sat with him years and years and years like it used to be before. So I'm not fanatical about any of them. So if there's any mistake that I find on the, in the books of Al-Albani, things that he said, I don't take them. It's just, to me, it's basic. You say the truth, bring the evidence, alhamdulillah. You have your own opinion about something, you're still my sheikh and my imam, but I don't take it without evidence. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge in the religion and make us among the righteous.
والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما